Every weekend now, the Hong Kong riot police and special tactical squads spoil the party. And these days, it's guaranteed to end in tears with volleys of CS gas.
PRC's treatment of Hong Kong, just like its treatment of the Uyghurs or the Tibetans, Beijing claims, as citizens, is an indicator of how Chinese rulers will behave abroad. All nations who trade with the PRC should be watching the drama unfolding on the streets of Hong Kong. The world is watching and wondering.
The world is watching. On July 21, 2019, Senator of the Congress, Senator Majority Leader McConnell gave a speech. Mitch McConnell is the longest in-office senator leader of the Republicans. He is the number 15th leader of the senator leader of the Republicans. He proposed and drafted the U.S. Hong Kong Police Act. The act was passed in August 1992. U.S. Hong Kong Police Act sees Hong Kong as a free trade zone. The United States Hong Kong Police Act passed in 1992 promised as long as Hong Kong have sufficient autonomy, U.S. will support Hong Kong's right under international laws. The U.S. Hong Kong Police Act sees Hong Kong as a free trading zone and gives it special tariffs benefits different from other parts of China. Until July 1, 1997, the free trading zone developed very fast. Financial groups from all countries highly regarded Hong Kong in terms of financial importance. Lots of investments were made and many economic entities moved there, which turned Hong Kong into a beautiful Pearl of the Orient. Due to brutal crackdowns on the anti-extradition bill protests and Hong Kong people who made the richest demands, Hong Kong gained attention of the world once again. Recently, a large PLA force has stationed near Hong Kong and the police forces from mainland China were transferred to Hong Kong and treated the people brutally. Many richest people were under arrest and reports from all over the world documented violent and bloody scenes. Due to continuous undermining of the one country, two systems model, Hong Kong's long-standing special stage in international affairs is now hanging by a thread. Many U.S. senators thought that the extradition bill will dramatically hurt the property's business environment in Hong Kong. They also worried that the current situation will affect the special ties between Hong Kong and USA. On July 24th, in his Congress remark, "The world is watching," McConnell said U.S. Congress and administration will re-examine its relationship with PRC and will continue to hold hearings on the subject of autonomy and the democracy of Hong Kong. The U.S.-Hong Kong relationship is on the verge of breaking. If this amendment bill proposed by McConnell is passed, it will be a heavy blow to Hong Kong. Hong Kong will lose its unique advantage. In fact, for a long time, Hong Kong has become the primary location used by the CCP's ruling oligarchies to transfer wealth. Therefore, canceling Hong Kong's unique financial position will be a fatal blow to CCP. We look forward to support from all over the world to Hong Kong to help free the people of Hong Kong from the tyranny of CCP. Hong Kong people must have autonomy. must have a general election to establish a real legitimate government. We firmly believe the world is watching will make the U.S. revisit U.S. Hong Kong Police Act, unite all the richest powers of the world to get rid of the vicious CCP government. This will help restore the stability and the health development of Hong Kong, Taiwan, China, and the whole Asia-Pacific region. At this moment, the whole world is with Hong Kong people. Go, Hong Kong! Free Hong Kong!
Touching Beijing's boundaries, but we're not afraid of that.
Are you really prepared to suffer the consequences of a crackdown by Beijing if it loses patience?
We're well aware of what happened in Tiananmen Square, and I believe a lot of people here are actually more than prepared for, you know, in case of an invasion by the PLA. Obviously, we know what might that lead to, but if we die, Hong Kong would die with us. That's our stance. If we burn, Hong Kong burns with us.
今天是报平安加紧急直播，刚刚的文贵获得共产党内部正在执行任务的内部的我们战友的内部的绝密信息，我们是第一家，我们获得信息，现在共产党已经全面下达了对香港执行戒严令的命令，初步计划是8月4号到6号之间，根据8月5号香港的行政政府的工作人员上街的情况，取决于8月4号凌晨1点或者是8月5号到8月，他们的规定是根据中华人民共和国所谓的国家安全法，根据中华人民共和国解放军驻港法，应香港政府之要求，对香港实施戒严。对香港实施戒严，这是非常恐怖的应香港政府之要求，根据中华人民共和国驻军法，解放军驻军驻港解放军法和所谓的国家安全法，对香港实施戒严。第二个呢，就是在香港的戒严期间，基本上限制了人只出不进。由成立的由香港政府和中国人民解放军驻港部队成立的戒严指挥部统一协调，那就是香港人的吃喝医药还有所谓的社会治安，全面由驻港部队和香港政府成立的戒严指挥部统一指挥，那就等于解放军接管了香港的管理权，一国两制彻底死亡只有一贼了，连国都没了盗国贼集团彻底接管香港一切， 人只许出不许进。第三个，据说对香港啊规定，对香港的特别是美国和英国啊外籍的真正外籍人士进行清理，并对美国和欧洲在香港的机构、行政机构和驻港人员进行清理。啊，第四个是将对六月九号以来上街抗议的积极人士，他们叫暴动分子，进行抓捕。啊，我再等一个消息，因为我没有闹清楚说的是一万还是几万，他刚就给我说了一个一，啊，这个一是一万，我理解是一万啊，但愿这个消息我不敢肯定，因为这个我们保这种联系方式太不安全啊，他给我说了个一。以上四条是来自于我们绝对可相信的内部的战友。
周末下午茶是由我们三位女义工联合制作，我们每个周末和大家一起在文磊的甜品屋喝喝茶聊聊天，连线热点人物，说说挺锅路上的你我他，好吧，每个周末我们不见不散。战友之声是所有挺锅战友的家，欢迎广大战友加入我们的 Discord 战友之声频道，在这里可以和广大战友一起聊聊天，一起探讨一下大家所关注的热点话题，还可以参加战友之声油管频道的节目互动，欢迎大家点击频道下方的链接加入我们，谢谢大家。法治基金是中国人民唯一的希望与未来，请观众们点击视频下方显示的法治基金官方链接，踊跃捐款法治基金，并留好您的票据，如有疑问请到战友之声寻求帮助。